गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम मुंशी रशीदुल इस्लाम, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग, JIS कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग। नाउ टुडे वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट ए न्यू पॉइंट विथ ए न्यू मॉड्यूल एंड ऑब्वियसली ए न्यू लेसन। दैट मीन्स द टुडे डिस्कसिंग पॉइंट एंड डिस्कसिंग एरिया विल बी इन द फ्रिक्शन। सो फ्रिक्शन इज द टुडेज टॉपिक। सो लेट अस सी the discussion points. Now the content will be in the today discussing point, that will be what is friction, limiting friction, types of friction, angle of friction, coefficient of friction, angle of repose, and laws of friction. So next, what is friction? So in one liner, friction happen. Friction is a phenomena when the two surfaces are in contact positions. But we think that most of the cases and most of the area that will exist in this earth, the friction is everywhere. So when a body slides or tends to slide on a surface on which it is resting, a resisting force opposing the motion is produced at the contact surface, and this resisting force is called the friction or friction force. So if I see the figure, so one body, that means the purple color body, are resting on a surface, that is suppose surface will be the green color surface. So if I push the body and friction will act just opposite direction of the pushing force. That means if I push towards right side, the friction force will act in towards left side. That is actually the friction. Now next point is limiting friction. The maximum friction force that can be developed at the contact surface and when body is just on the point of moving is called limiting of friction. So that means if I apply a force, suppose a body which is actually resting on a surface, so total body weight will act in downward direction. That means W is equal to m into g, and normal reaction will act in upward direction. That means a capital N. And now if I push the force, now before starting the movement of the body, just before starting the movement of the body, that force is required. Which force is required? That force is called as a limiting force. Now types of friction. A lot of type of frictions are included in this syllabus. So first one is static friction. So friction which is actually experienced by a body when it is at rest, and that situation it is called as static friction. Dynamic friction, the friction which is experienced by a body when it is in motion is called as dynamic friction. Next, sliding friction. Sliding friction, the friction experienced by a body when it slides over another body and is called as sliding friction. Next, rolling friction. And in rolling friction, the friction is experienced by a body when it rolls over another body and is called as a rolling friction. And this is actually the case of the friction, how it can be developed. So at static conditions, there will be no movement, only the surface body are raised on above the surface. So that's why if I apply force on the left hand side with red colored arrow, so obviously the friction will act between the two surfaces, that means the ground surface and the body lower portion. So the friction force will act to the opposite sides of the applying force. So in this situation, no motion can be required. Next, sliding motion, obviously it is responsible. That means sliding friction. When the one body is slides over the another surface, so in between these two surfaces, the friction will develop, and in this situation, the friction is called the sliding friction, and that is the rolling friction. That means the one roller can roll over a surface, and during the rolling, one force obviously act in opposite direction of the applying force. That force, during this situation, force is called as a rolling friction. Now, angle of friction. Now, if I first of all, if you see the figure clearly, one body which is resting at a above the a surface, and first of all you split up the whole figure into the component base. That means the body weight, that will be W will act in downward direction. Now the force is applied, that means capital P is applied towards the right hand side of the figure, and normal reaction R will act in upward direction. So the limiting friction will act in left hand direction, and the theta that will be a angle of friction. So angle between the normal reaction and the resultant force R, normal reaction and the resultant force R, is called as the angle of friction. So the angle between the normal reaction A and the resultant force R resultant force is called as the angle of friction, and it is also called the limiting angle of friction. Coefficient of friction. The ratio of limiting force F and the normal reaction N is called the coefficient of friction. That means it is denoted by mu. So mu is equal to F by N. So mu is equal to F by N, where F is equal to friction force and N is equal to normal reaction. And now this is actually the case of diagram, applied force versus frictional force. So applied force, if I consider applied force is F and the friction force is small f, so in static friction the graph will increase diagonally in between the two forces, and there will be no changes. But in actual cases, the sliding friction will be the mu s into r, and the rolling friction obviously mu k into r, and the static friction will be a diagonal value of these two forces. Angle of repose. With increase in angle of the inclined surface, the maximum angle at which the body starts sliding down is called as angle of friction. That means angle of repose, not friction. That means suppose one body which is actually resting on a inclined surface and just sliding, starting the sliding, and on this situation the angle between at which the body starts sliding down in an inclined plane, and that angle is called as angle of repose. And angle of repose is called by the phi value. So in this figure, the body weight W will act in downward direction, and if if I split the whole figure, the two components will get. That means lower component is W cos phi, and the opposite sides we can get W sin phi. So that is actually the case of, and obviously the limiting friction is opposite direction towards the P point. And now, angle of repose, how it can be vary in this regard. With increase in the angle of the inclined surface, the maximum angle at which the body starts sliding is called angle of repose. The resolve perpendicular to the plane, that means n is equal to W cos phi. Resolve parallel to the plane, that means F is equal to W sin phi. And obviously mu is equal to F by n. So F is equal to W sin phi, and n is equal to W cos phi. So WW cancel, mu is equal to tan phi. So we know that mu is equal to tan phi. And from this equation, from 1 and 2, mu is equal to tan phi and mu is equal to tan theta. So from these two equations, we can get theta is equal to phi. That means where alpha is equal to angle of inclined plane. And hence, when the angle of inclined plane phi becomes equal to the limiting angle of body, so on this situation, the body will slide down to the plane. And in this regard, we can say the angle of repose is equal to angle of friction. Cone of friction. It is defined as an imaginary cone that will form by the resultant of the normal reaction N and the limiting friction for frictional force F about the normal reaction N for one complete revolution. For one complete revolution. So that's why we can write as per the cone basis. So mu is equal to tan phi. Ladder friction. So a ladder is fixed at an inclined plane with some certain angle, and one side is fixed to the upper portion and another side is fixed with horizontal surface. So the ladder is a device for climbing or scaling the roofs or wall. It is made of wood or iron, and there are the long pieces in the ladder to which many small cross pieces called rags are connected at equal distance to the work as steps. So some consideration also be considered. That means first self weight of ladder is W, weight of the man standing on the ladder, reaction by the floor on the ladder, that means RA. Friction force between the ladder and floor is Ra, that is equal to mu into Ra, and the reaction by wall on the ladder is small Rb, and the friction force between the ladder and wall is Fp is equal to Rb into mu. So laws of friction, different types of laws of frictions are also there: static friction, dynamic friction, and this is actually the equation problem. Static friction. The friction force is always acting in direction and opposite to that of the body tends to move. Number one. Number two, the magnitude of friction force is equal to the external force. That means F is equal to P. The ratio of the limiting force F and the normal reaction N is constant. That means mu is equal to F by N. The friction force does not depend upon the area of the contact between the two surfaces. and the friction force depends upon the roughness of the surfaces. Laws of dynamic friction. The dynamic friction similar to that of the static friction, but one direction consideration is different for the static. That means the for the moderate speed, the friction force remains constant, but it is decreased slightly with the increase of speed. And that is actually one practical problem that can be discussed in the next class, because the some application can be some equation can also be described due in, so that's why that problem is not solved in this class. This problem can be solved in the next class. So thank you for today's class.